Hi, I'm Dave Celentano with Guitar Tricks, and today I'm going to show you how to read tablature, or commonly called tab. It's very easy, and you can do it too, even if you're a beginner. Tab is a simple system of music notation with six horizontal lines and numbers placed on them. Each line represents a string on the guitar, and the numbers are the frets on the particular string to place your finger. When reading tablature, the bottom line is represented by the sixth string on our guitar, and that's actually the top string on our guitar. It's the fattest one, the thickest one. So remember that it's upside down or on the bottom end of the tablature staff. And then conversely, you got the first string on our guitar is the skinniest one, the one closest to the floor, and in tablature, that's the one up top, right there. So just remember that it's upside down relative to the way we look at our guitar. And then all the other strings follow suit. So start with your sixth string in the bass, the low E, then it goes 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and ascends in pitch up to the skinniest high E string. So tablature actually does make a lot of sense when you understand that it's written from the perspective of the lowest sounding notes are at the bottom of the staff, and then the higher sounding notes are on the top of the staff. Works up gradually from low to high like that. So that's a good way to think about how the tab staff is viewed and how we're going to work with that. A great way to remember the letter names of the six strings is think of a sentence with six words, and each one of them words starts with one of the letters of the six strings in order. So one that works super good for a lot of my students that I give them is starting with the sixth string, the E. We're going to go, every animal does good before eating. Or another fun one to do, the kids like this one, Eddie ate dynamite, goodbye Eddie. So there you go. There's two little tricks that could very well help you remember the letter names of your six strings. That'll help a lot too with your understanding of reading tablature as we proceed forward more with learning songs and all kinds of fun stuff on the guitar. Now looking at the numbers placed on the tab staff, the numbers represent the frets. And for instance, a one placed on the bottom line in tablature represents the sixth string first fret, and that would be one of the lower sounding notes on your guitar. A one placed on the top line in tablature, the first string, would be represented like this, the first string or high E and the first fret on our guitar, and it sounds higher. So that gives us a good idea orientation-wise as to how we're going to look at the tablature staff relative to our guitar. And tablature is read just like music or literature from left to right. So when we got a series of numbers on a particular string or strings, but they're moving from left to right, they're to be played one at a time in succession like this. For instance, if we have the open sixth string, that would be represented by a zero on the sixth line. Then we got a one, that would be a one on the sixth string, or bottom line of tablature. A two on the same line is second fret on the sixth string. A three, and then back down, just to give you an illustration. So those notes are to be played one at a time in succession, or whatever the fret numbers are that you're reading. Even if it crosses to a different line, you still read them in succession. If I were to play an open sixth string, and then the next note's on the fifth line, second fret, that would be played here, and then maybe the next note's on the fourth string, second fret, that would be here. And they would be played one at a time, like that. The other way we'll see numbers on tablature is if they're stacked. So usually you'll see two or more stacked vertically. That means to be played all together as one unit or one chord. Usually it's some part of a chord if they're played together. So for instance, if we have a zero on string four, a zero on string three, a zero on string two, and a three on string one, and they're stacked vertically rather than staggered, that means to play all those notes at the same time. So that would be the upper part of a G chord, for instance. Okay? And then that gives you a good idea about how to read the different elements of how the numbers will be organized in tablature. Hammer-ons in tablature are when two notes will be on the same string and we'll pick the first one. For instance, we'll be on the third string, second fret. And then the next note will be the same string at the fourth fret. That second note does not get picked though. It's gonna get a hammer effect or technique from your third finger or whatever finger you're gonna hammer with. And it comes down straight directly and firmly onto the fourth fret, so you get a note. You wanna make it sound like you picked the note, but we didn't. Actually, your ring finger struck the note hard enough so it sounds like we picked it. And that's indicated by the two numbers, a little slur marking, which is a curved line over them, and then an H for hammer-on. Another technique we'll see a lot of is pull-offs. They're the opposite of a hammer-on. So for instance, let's do the same two notes, the fourth fret on the third string and second fret. Now when we do pull-offs, it's really smart to have both fingers planted before you play anything. So look ahead, see what's gonna be pulled off to, get the fingers lined up on it, and then you'll pick the higher of the two notes, and then your ring finger in this case will pull off. It lifts off. It doesn't lift off perpendicular because we won't hear it. It's kind of a weak sound. We actually want to make a downwards pulling or flicking motion. So we're, in essence, we're kind of plucking the string with that third finger. Pick, and then when you pull off, you don't pick that second note. The finger on your left hand plucks off to the lower finger. And then you want to get that note to be about the same volume. And that's also notated between the two notes with a little curved line over the top, a slur marking, and it's got a P over it for pull off. Slides are similar to a hammer-on and pull-off, but you only use one finger. And let's try it on a different string. Let's take the second string, third fret. We'll place the index finger there. And then remember, the second string on your guitar is the second string from the top in the tablature staff. We're gonna be on the third fret, pick that note, and then we quickly slide the first finger up to the fifth fret. Okay, now to do that properly, you're gonna need to keep your finger pressure applied the whole time in order to get that second note to sound. If for some reason you get up there and the note doesn't sound, it's because you release pressure along the way. So we've gotta really dig in, push hard with your index finger or whatever finger's doing the slide and get it up to the second note. It's a great way to build finger calluses. And then you get a nice sound there, and you can do a slide with any finger. Also, slides work in reverse order too. It's the same technique, but in reverse. Let's play the fifth fret on the second string, and we're gonna pluck that note, and then slide back to the third fret. Gotta keep your finger pressed down the whole time so that second note still rings. And slides are indicated like hammer-ons and pull-offs with a little curved line over the top, a slur mark. But between the two numbers, there'll be a diagonal line either ascending or descending, depending on which direction the pitch of the slide is going. So obviously a 3-5 slide would be an ascending slide. The line would go up. If we did a 5-3 slide, it's a descending slide, so the line's gonna go down between those two notes. String bends is another tool technique that you'll see a lot of in, especially electric guitar playing. Acoustic guitar players do it a little bit, but not quite as much because the strings are pretty thick. But anyway, a string bend on guitar, if we grab the eighth fret, for instance, on the second string, you're gonna grip it with your third finger, and usually we have another finger behind it to help it. Just push that up a whole step, is about how far they usually go, and a whole step is equivalent to two frets on the guitar. We usually wanna bend to a predetermined note rather than just some random out of tune note. So usually the note we bend to is another note in the scale, something that sounds good. And one of the most common bends is a full step bend or a whole step, which is, like I mentioned, two frets. So if you play the note two frets higher, you can hear what the 8 will sound like. It's supposed to sound like the 10th fret, but we push the 8 up in pitch so that it reaches the 10th fret's pitch. And that's notated with a little curved arrow going upwards to the right of the tablature number. And then if it's a full step bend, it usually has a 1 written over the arrow tip, indicating one whole step or one full step. Another thing you'll see in tablature is the bar line, which is a vertical line that separates each bar or measure of music. And usually for most of the stuff we listen to, it's gonna be 4 beats per bar or 3 beats There are other numeric breakdowns, but for right now, we'll just focus on the four. So every four beats, they put a vertical line in the tablature staff, and that helps us to see and hear nice, small, compact rhythm chunks in four beats at a time. It's easy to digest, and it makes it a lot easier to learn the parts of the song. So you might focus on one bar of music or one measure of music at a time when learning it, and having the bar line there is a great way to divide it up for you. So there you go. Well, that covers the basics to getting you started reading tablature. Keep in mind, tablature and the associated guitar techniques mentioned here are applicable to acoustic and electric guitar. It's like a new language and gets easier the more you use it. Now start using Tab by learning a song or two from the Guitar Tricks site at guitartricks.com.